believe that I have just flown this.
Okay, Jack, can you hear me okay? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, can you hear me? Yes. Okay, that's good, it's loud and clear now, that's good. Right, okay, so we've established communication. I'm just going to check that we've got full movement on the controls, there we go. And the throttle. And we're ready to start now. Okay, Malcolm.
Okay.
Okay, so he's just going to start there.
So the engine started on the second blade, so that was quite good. And can you still hear me okay, John?
Yes, I can hear you perfectly.
Okay, that's good. So while we're waiting for that, the engine to warm up, just a little bit about the history of the aircraft. So this particular one was built in 1935, so just before the Second World War. It was a civilian aircraft to start off with. And then during the Second World War, I think all civilian aircraft were requisitioned by the military. So this was used in the RAF for training RAF pilots during the war. But then after the war, in about 1946, it was handed back to civilian use and has been in civilian use ever since. Noisy on the takeoff because the engine's on full power and for the initial climb out. So I won't do any talking till we get up to a reasonable height and then we'll level off, throttle the engine back, and then it'll be much easier to hear what I'm saying.
Okay.
Are you alright for parking? I'm alright for parking, thank you.
Right, there we are. We've climbed 1,200 feet since we took off, and I've just throttled the engine back to cruising power. And you can see a lovely view all around us at the moment. We've got the town of Shaftesbury just on the right-hand side coming up. We'll go right over the top of that and have a look down on top of it. The visibility today is exceptional. Just looking ahead of us there, just to the left of the nose, I would reckon the visibility there is probably about 40 miles. You're looking out towards Wincanton, and then beyond that, right out...
Nevertheless, it's fantastic up here.
It's a lovely way to see the